Hello, in today's video I'm testing this new setup with this new camera to see how this goes. So it will be kind of a walkthrough of how to set up a cheap focker too. So thanks to Shaman and everyone that participated in making this project. Possible thanks to Vedder for what he did. So here I have the components for the order. Just follow the tutorial on GitHub. And here I have the PCBs, so we will make one of them. For this I will use the soldering iron and station. So what else do I need? I need my protection glasses and two. So here we are back again. So for the ones that don't know what a cheap focker is, it's a VESC. It's a VESC, yes. So it's an ESC, it's an electric speed controller that can go up to 50 amps if I'm not wrong. And it uses, it's open source and open hardware, and you can flash the firmware. It's firmware. Okay, so I have to keep things here. So the first thing is to get the MOSFETs. We need six of them. I've already done a few that you can see here. So this one is a finished one. So the first thing is to do the MOSFETs. We'll try to do things as cleanly as we can. As clean as we can. So two, then I need to get two from here. I need to get four from here. Sorry for the noise. I have to keep it this way because if I solder, I need to open the window so that the smoke gets at least evacuated a bit. So the first thing we need to do is, this is also just a walkthrough of the tutorial. The first thing we need to do is this, to put the transistors this way. So get a pair of pliers and fold them. if you can see very well. I hope so. So now that all of the components are soldered, so well, what am I saying? My head is not. Now that all of the MOSFETs are bended. I need to put some thermal glue on this one. So for this one, so that the current sensing resistors can know the temperature, you need to put some thermal glue. I have here some. Is it better if I do this? No, I don't think so. Is it better? Yeah, I think this. No. Let me just move the light and see if I can do something better. I hope that this is better. I moved the lamp elsewhere. So, the thermal paste, just a bit. It's dry. How can I still dry. So one thing you should know is that there is thermal paste, like this one, thermal glue and thermal paste. And from what I've learned, thermal paste doesn't solidify. I'll just do this one so that I don't need to. Redo it again. Maybe I've put a bit too much. And now they need to be parallel. Okay, now I need to solder the first few pads. Turning on the soldering iron. it's a temperature. Wearing my soldering gloves. Very thin solder, I think this is 0.6, something like this. I'll start with the other one, just so that it's done. So it really needs to be applied, so put some pressure on it to be sure that it's correctly done, and then so one thing to remember is when you solder, you need both junctions to be at the same temperature, otherwise it will not stick very well. Otherwise you will have cold solders. That's it. That's it for this one. Now I need to do the same for this one. A bit more times. So for this one, we'll just do one foot, one. Juncture at the time. Don't hesitate to check them. So now I will work with this third hand. Okay, so the next step is to bend the legs. So you should follow the guide, and the guide tells us to do it this way. It's easier to see on this one. To do it this way. So if you turn your board like this, if you have a look. So the first leg needs to go this way, the second one needs to go this way, this one needs to go this way, and then all of the others will be trained, and it's the same for all of them. Voila. Try, if you can, try to put as much space between these two. Don't put this one over the hole, otherwise you will not be able to have the cable going through it. And now we will put some solder here, here, and here. Then solder them. You can be generous on these pads, and they can be they can short this temperature sensing resistors. So is there, okay, let's see how we can do this while staying. I'm not sure about this, but should be enough. Yeah, okay. One thing I forgot. So you can see here that the problem is warming up this pad. But as soon as it's achieved, it shouldn't have any problem. And as I said, you can be generous on this one. Just pay attention so it doesn't touch. I'll check it later. Then I will solder these. Perfect. Which I need to move the whole thing. What was that? Oh no. Okay, I guess it's fixed. Same story here. So perfect, should be done. So now I just need to do a visual inspection. So I need a few seconds for that. It looks pretty decent or not. There are a few things I would like to improve. So, one of them being this pad. It's too close. From the other one, I don't like that, it should be better now. And the other one being these small pads that I would like to see with more solder on. Perfect. I think this one is sorry, you can't see this one, but I need to just fix the short here. Go away. nothing. So these are the kind of problems you will get if you do everything right. It shouldn't happen, but it often does. And one thing you can do is to check your connections. I think I'm not sure, but actually I am sure this can be fatal. So check the ones that are supposed to be connected, and the ones, I forgot to solder this one, and check the ones that are not supposed to be connected. You see? Okay, let's see how we can fix this. So, first thing first, fix this thing. I forgot it. Seems like fixed. Okay, it seems like there's nothing between anymore. Perfect. So one last visual inspection. If you have a microscope, of course, better. Now we can trim all of the edges. Not the edges, the pads. Again, visual inspection can go a long way. So one other thing that is recommended to be done is to solder the pads here. I turned off my soldering iron. Perfect. This looks nice. As I said earlier, check. Perfect. Now we only have a few other things left to do. So the SMD components. What do we need? Or maybe not this time. So we will put the SMD components and then use the heat gun to solder them. For this I have some thermal paste. Not thermal paste, how is it called? Solder paste. The only problem I have is that I don't know how to push it. I mean, I'm sure there is a way. I'm sure it's not supposed to be, you know, using something, but I didn't figure it out yet. Yeah, okay, so we have, what do we have? We have this coil that will go here, will go here. We have three capacitors that will go here, and we have one small, I think it's a resistor, that will go here. Let's start with the resistor. So let's put some solder paste there. Oh no! What's the problem? I need some. I forget it open, that's what I'm afraid of, you know, if it dry it does. It doesn't look good because here it starts coming on the other side. Okay. So that's one good thing done. Then we need component, we need a small pair of precise pliers. And then we warm up the heat gun, reduce the flow, and you should be able to see it reflow. Starting. Even if you've put a bit too much, it shouldn't be a problem. No, it didn't go well. So sometimes it doesn't go very well and you need to replace it. But now it looks good. Looks good. You can use a normal soldering iron for this, and one thing at a time. Where are they? Yeah, so you shouldn't have some on your fingers because it has lead, so I need to wash my hands afterward. Actually, I think I will wash them now as soon as I done this one. Okay, this one's nice. Back. So we'll do the last few. The capacitors. So we need three of these. waiting for the gun to be warm. Why is this taking so long? So one thing I was expecting that I shouldn't have done is the plastic is melting, the tape is melting. This is a fire hazard. The first one is done. So as far as I know, it's not too much of a problem to have connection short between these two. Yeah, there is one anyways. Done. So these are the only SMD components that need to be soldered. Visual inspection as usual, this looks good. One missing thing are the capacitors. So I have two here. And then the connectors. Some of them are a bit hard to solder. So for the capacitors we need the minus on, we need the minus on this side. For both of them. It's actually written. No, it's not. No, it's not. But in the documentation it should be written. So we still need to solder these. And then we will solder a few other components and then we will be over. The next step would be to solder this USB connector, which is, in my opinion, one of the hardest, and then to solder a 5-pin I think it's this one, component. Ready. Warm up the pad a bit. Done. Of course, you would need to add the cables, so the input here, and the output here, three faces, so this one's good. Double check the polarity of the capacitors. Now, this thing, which in my opinion is a bit hard. So, how do I go about this? I just put it somewhere, solder one part, and then move it, and then solder the rest. Visual inspection. This looks good. Oh, I did it on the wrong side. No. It should be on this side. It should be on this side, not on this side. Whatever. Oh, and you need to add the heatsink afterwards. I don't have the right heatsinks, but you should add it something like this. One other important part is this. Yeah, okay, this one is on the right side. So again, you can, for example, if you have a third hand like this one, you can hold them together, I guess. I don't know if you can, you barely can see it. to be even more careful on this one, because if you stay too long, the plastic can melt. And we are done. Now the next step would be to test it. That's what we will do. For this, I have a power supply that you cannot see, but I will put current limit on it. Able to hear it though. So the negative to the negative and the positive to the positive. Before doing anything, we should check that we don't have a short in between the positive and the negative, otherwise we have a problem somewhere. Okay, for some reason actually there is a test. You should get some value if you test between, you should get 500 if you test the negative at the positive and the positive at the negative, and you should get, it's a diode test, and you should get an open circuit the other way around. So this is good. Now positive to red, negative to negative. So now I would put 32 volts limited at 100 milliamps. If you don't have a limiting power supply, if you do have, use it. If you don't have a limiting power supply, in the official repo, you can, there are some advices on other power supplies you can use, mainly ones made for smartphones, limited at 100 milliamps. So I will power it on, and we shouldn't reach the current limit. And here we see we have a blue light. It's not flashed, so that's normal that we don't get anything more. But here we go. We can see 0.01 amp at 32 volts. It's using 0.32 watts. If I reduce it to 5 volts, five volts, 100 milliamps limitation, we are still using 0.01 amp. And you can see the blue LED. In the next video, we will flash it using this. So it's a ST-Link. And we will plug it this way. So actually just need to respect you, we have here the reset connected to the reset, if I'm not wrong. Yes, the reset connected to the reset. Then we have the 3.3 volts, no, yeah, the 3.3 volts, the ground connected to respectively. So the 3.3 volt is the blue. No, the 3.3 volt is the this pink. Pink is connected to VCC. The ground is connected to ground. The reset is connected to reset. And there are two left, which are SW clock and SWDIO. And they are connected to violet and green, SWDIO and SW clock. Exactly the same. So just respect the naming and you should be all set. And but we will still do it to see, to have a proper walkthrough. I hope that this was helpful. Thank you for watching.